everybody. This is Jack Drees with the opening of Western Conference football for 1952 at Ann Arbor, Michigan. It's Michigan playing host to their cross-state rivals, the Spartans from Michigan State, before some 97,000 highly partisan fans. The first game of this historic series was won in 1898 by Michigan, 39-0. With such greats of Michigan grit annals as Charlie Whitman, Neil Snow, Hugh White, contributing greatly for the maize and blue. But the Spartans are here today to make it 3 in a row over Michigan under Coach Biggie Munn. Key man in the Spartan attack is quarterback Tom Usyk and 1952 captain Don McAuliffe, Spartan All-American candidate. The crowd eagerly awaits the start of this great game, and they roar a greeting as the Wolverine pack trots on the field. One of its outstanding stars is veteran quarterback Ted Topher. Dick O'Shaughnessy promises to be in the middle of the Michigan attack. As the Michigan State band marches onto the field, the captains of the two opposing teams are moving to the center of the field for the toss of the coin. Heads or tails will decide who'll kick off, but first here's a brief word from Bob Carson.
Supposing that cable should break. But of course it won't break. It's more than safe. It's super safe. And so is Phillips 66 Heavy Duty Premium Motor Oil. It actually surpasses highest recommendations set by manufacturers for all makes of cars. It's not just a safe enough oil, it's super safe. And that's why Phillips Petroleum Company can make this guarantee. Try a crankcase full of Phillips 66 heavy-duty premium motor oil for 10 days or up to 1,000 miles. Then, if you aren't satisfied on every count, go to any Phillips 66 dealer, and he will refill your car's crankcase with any other available oil you want at Phillips' expense. This certificate is your guarantee of satisfaction. Get Phillips 66 heavy-duty premium motor oil. Remember, it's guaranteed to satisfy you.
Michigan coach Benny Oosterbaan gathers his team around him on the sidelines for that last pregame huddle before the opening kickoff. It's Michigan kicking off to Michigan State. Russ Rescorla doing the booting. And there goes the ball, and the game is on. It's a low kick, and it bounds back toward the Michigan State goal line with Jim Ellis chasing it, scooping it up around the 5-yard line, starting back up the field but not getting very far. He's hit at the 11, and it'll be Michigan State's ball, first and 10 at that point. Spartans have the ball on their own 11-yard line. Direct pass from center goes to Vince Pizan. Through the middle of the line, goes up the field for a gain of 6 yards on the play. That makes it second down and 4 yards to go on the Michigan State 17-yard line. Tommy Usyk hands off to Don McAuliffe. McAuliffe cracks through for a 3-yard gain. Then Michigan State was penalized 5 yards for delaying the game to make it 3rd and 6 on their own 15, and they go into punt formation with Tommy Usyk back. Slow getting the kick away, he just gets it away from under the arms of a fast-coming blocker. It's a high kick, and Michigan State has plenty of time to get down under the ball. Michigan can't run it back. They're letting it roll dead, and it rolls to a halt on Michigan's 41-yard line. Michigan's ball now, 1st and 10, no score in the game, and they're on their own 41. Single wing to the right. The highly regarded tailback Ted Kress getting the ball from center, swinging inside the right end and cutting up the field for a gain of 9 yards on the play. That puts the ball just on the Michigan State side of the 50-yard line. It's 2nd down and 1 yard to go for the Wolverines. Again, the shift is over to the right. Press with the ball. Nice block on the end. He cuts inside, goes for a 1st down as he gains 6 on the play, and that moves the ball down to the Michigan State 44-yard line. 1st and 10 for Michigan. We're on the Spartans 44 with Ted Kress again getting the ball. Back he goes to pass, throws a little quick pass to Ted Topher, his quarterback. Pass is complete, and it's good for 8 yards. But Michigan was unable to penetrate further. And after a Michigan punt, we pick up Michigan State with the ball game still at 0-0. 1st and 10 for the Spartans. The handoff from their own 9-yard line goes to Dick Pannon, the fullback, who's through for a gain of 5 yards. Dave Tinkham made the tackle. 2nd down and 5. Michigan State's ball on their own 14-yard line. The line is strong to the right. They go from the wing tee with Tommy Usyk, the quarterback, dropping back to throw a forward pass. Vince Paisano's the target. The ball is on his way, but it's too far. It falls to the ground incomplete. So that makes it third and five. Michigan State's ball on their own 14, and they go into punt formation with Tommy Usick back once again to do the booting. A high twisting kick, Lowell Perry, the Michigan safety man, getting under the ball, and he takes it and swings off to the left sidelines. This boy can really swivel hip and watch him go. Right roping along the sidelines, he gets past the first tackler but steps out of bounds. A 33-yard return to the Michigan State 23-yard line. That made it first and 10 for Michigan on the Michigan State 23, and one play later, it's second and 5, now on the Michigan State 18-yard line. This time the Wolverines go out of the T formation. Ted Topel with the ball. Starts out as a pass play, but he can't find a target. He's going to have to run with it. Gets past the line of scrimmage and is dumped after a gain of 4 yards by Doug Weaver. So it's third and 1 now on the Michigan State 14-yard line. Ted Crest back, taking the pass from center. Inside right end once again. This time it's good for a gain of 5 yards. That made it a first down. And on the next play, they gained 4 yards. And it's now second and 6 on the Michigan State 5-yard line. Again, it's Ted Crest with the ball. And this time he goes outside the end. He's streaking toward that goal line, and no one can stop him. He's in there for a Michigan touchdown. Well, this is indeed a startling turn of events. Michigan State, rated by most as the number one team of the country, as a Michigan 11 explode in their faces and draw the first scoring blood in this game. It's 6-0, Michigan over Michigan State. They missed the point after touchdown. Following the kickoff, Michigan State failed again, and we pick up Michigan with the ball once again. First and 10 now on the Michigan State 38-yard line. Man in motion goes out to the right. Operating from the tee, Ted Topa, the quarterback, drops back to throw one. He's a southpaw passer in his left end. Lowell Perry is the target. He has the ball, and he's in the clear. It's Lowell Perry going in for another Michigan score. The point after touchdown, pushing the score to Michigan 13, Michigan State nothing, as Russ Rescorla kicks off. A low bouncing kick, Jim Ellis scoops it up. Swinging for the far sidelines as he nears the 30-yard stripe, he is bumped out of bounds. Gene Knudsen and Tom Witherspoon coming in on the tackle, and it's first and 10 on the Michigan State 30-yard line. Michigan State has the ball, and they trail in this ball game by the unbelievable margin of 13-0. Handoff goes to Don McAuliffe. Beautiful blocking there as McAuliffe swings wide around right end. He gets past the first wave of defenders, threads his way through the rest, and suddenly McAuliffe breaks into the clear, and he is off for a Michigan State touchdown. 70 yards. They added the extra point to bring the first quarter to a close with the score, Michigan 13, Michigan State 7. Early in the second quarter, we pick up Michigan State, first and 10, on the Michigan 44-yard line. Wayne Benson, the fullback, takes it and keeps it on the fake buck lateral. Goes into the middle of the line for a gain of 1 yard to make it second and 9 on the Michigan 43. Usick, the quarterback, back to throw a forward pass. Sends one arching through the air. Ellis Duckett is getting under the ball, and he has it. Gathers it in on the 10 and goes down to the 4-yard line where he fumbles it out of bounds. That was a gain of 39 yards on the play, and it makes it Michigan State first and goal to go on the Michigan 4-yard line. Leroy Bolden, the fullback, taking the handoff with good blocking in front of him, aims for that corner in the goal line, and he makes it. Michigan State has scored. That ties up the ball game at 13-13. Michigan State failed to convert. And it left the ball game with a tied score of 13-13 as the Spartans prepare to kick off. Gene LaKenta doing the booting. Sends a kick bounding down to Lowell Perry, who takes it on the 3-yard line. Swings back up the field, runs into trouble around the 20, and is stopped on the 23. Michigan continued to move, moving the ball out to their own 47, where we now pick up the play. First down, 10 yards to go. Hand off to the right halfback, Frank Howell. He swings over left tackle, moves on up the field, and almost breaks into the clear, is finally hauled down by the safety man after a gain of 30 yards. So that makes it first and 10 for Michigan on the Michigan State 23-yard line. Ball game tied at 13 and 13. Michigan once again getting down deep into Spartan territory. Operating out of the tee, the handoff goes to Frank Howell. He cracks over the middle of the line, fumbles. It's recovered by Jim Ellis for Michigan State. Michigan State has the ball, first and 10, and they're on their own 14-yard line. Wingback is out wide to the right. They're in the T formation. Direct pass from center, however, goes back to Wayne Benson, the fullback, and he powers his way over the right side of the line to go for a gain of 10 yards and another first down for the Spartans. Now it's Michigan State first and 10. They're on their own 24-yard line. Tight-knit line, unbalanced to the right. Handoff goes to Bill Wells. And on the crossbuck, he goes through for a gain of 4 yards. Laurie LeClaire made the tackle. Second down, 6. Michigan State's ball on their own 28. Now they shift out of the tee into the single wing. Ball to the fullback, he spins, hands off to Bill Wells. Bill Wells cracks back over left guard and goes for a gain of 5 yards. Roger Zatkoff made the tackle. And it's third down and a yard to go for Michigan State on their own 34. 1 yard from a first down. Going from the tee, the handoff is to McAuliffe. He gets through for a short gain, but it's enough for a first down. First and 10 for Michigan State. In the first play in the series of downs, they lost 2 yards. And now it's second and 12 on their own 34-yard line. Right halfback Bill Wells carrying again. He cuts inside the end, swings on up the field, and rambles for a gain of 17 yards before he is jolted to the ground. That puts Michigan State into Michigan territory. First and 10 on the Wolverines' 49-yard line. The ball game is tied at 13 to 13. And off to Don McAuliffe. McAuliffe fades back to throw a forward pass. Paul Decker's the target. There goes the ball. A high arching jump pass, and Decker has it. A beautiful catch. 39 yards gained on the play. Now Michigan State has it first and goal to go on the Michigan 10-yard line. This time the right halfback, Billy Wells, takes the ball, cracks over left tackle, and powers his way into the end zone for a touchdown. Michigan State goes into the lead, 19-13. Evan Slonak will try the extra point. Ball is placed down, there's the kick, and it's good. That makes the score Michigan 13, Michigan State 20. Gene LaCanta kicking off for the Spartans. It's a short kick. Tad Stanford gathers in the ball and brings it back to the Michigan 39-yard line. Don Drake, center for Michigan State, brought him down, and it's first and 10 for the Wolverines. They have the ball on their own 39-yard line. Going out of the tee, Frank Howell, the halfback, takes the ball, swings around wide to the left, goes through for a gain of 9 yards. Failing to gain a first down, we find them now fourth down, 8 yards to go. Michigan State's 48-yard line. Bill Billings is back in punt formation for Michigan. He aims the kick for the sidelines and really drills it. It's going down deep into Coffin Corner, and it goes out of bounds on the 4-yard line as the first half comes to an end. Michigan 13, Michigan State 20.
This is Mr. Tuttle, and he's headed for trouble. Tire trouble. Too bad, because just last week he ruined one good tire by smashing a curb too hard. Now his budget is due for another shock. Yep, here she comes. Look out, Tuttle. Oh, brother. Mr. Tuttle's out the price of another tire. Hey, Tuttle, why don't you buy Lee tires with the road hazard guarantee? It protects you for 15 months against all road hazards such as these. Things that could happen to any tire. Mr. Tuttle, if you had had this Lee guarantee, you wouldn't have lost all that money. Now you're talking, Tuttle. You're buying a terrific tire. It has to be good to give you that amazing 15-month road hazard guarantee. Lee tires are built to give you every extra except cost. They're available wherever you see the orange and black Phillips 66 shield. Liberal trade-in and easy terms if you wish. Protect your pocketbook with Lee guaranteed tires now.
This is Jack Greaves once again as we pause for a few moments in this great game today to pay tribute to the host school, the University of Michigan and its 17,000 students. A University of Michigan campus landmark and a familiar route for students is the Engine Arch in the West Engineering Building. The administration building at the University of Michigan was completed in 1948. Along with the administrative staff, many groups providing services to students also have offices in the building. Its fifth floor is occupied by the university's radio station. The University of Michigan regards the proper housing of women students as vitally important to their academic and personal success. One of the 10 dormitories provided for the women is Mosier Hall. Built in 1930, it has a capacity for 250 girls. Michigan's Department of English has an excellent reading program. And one of the devices used to increase a student's reading speed is the reading accelerator. It is a device with a shutter which moves over material being read, forcing the reader to read at least as fast as the shutter is moving. It provides a means by which the individual student can set clear goals and pace his steady increase in speed. This and other devices are being used in the department to increase the student's reading speeds. Personal and individual guidance for every student has been and still is the primary concern of the University of Michigan. It takes great pride in its achievements, for they are the result not alone of its professional staff, but also of all the hundreds of thousands of its students, alumni, and friends everywhere. And now back to the second half of the football game. Michigan State out in front 20-13, and Michigan State is kicking off to start the second half. Gene LaCanta doing the booting, and he sends one high and far. Don Oldham is waiting for it, takes it in on the 6-yard line, swings in behind his blockers, and kites up the field for a run back of about 26 yards before he's finally hauled down. That makes it first and 10 for Michigan on their own 32-yard line. Single wing comes over to the right. Ball comes back to Ted Kress, the tailback. He swings inside right tackle, picks up 4 yards on the play. That makes it second down and 6 yards to go for Michigan, and they're on their own 36-yard line. Out of the tee, the handoff goes to Frank Howell. He cracks over right tackle and goes for a gain of 8 yards and a first down for Michigan. A 5-yard gain made it second and 5 on the Michigan 48-yard line as we pick up the play. Single wing over to the right. Ted Kress taking the pass from center. A quick jump pass goes to Lowell Perry, complete and good for 6 yards and another Michigan first down. First and 10 now. Michigan's ball on the Michigan State 42. Again, that drifting halfback takes the handoff. That's Howell with the ball going wide to the left. And he's tripped up after a gain of 7 yards. Now Michigan has it second down, 3 yards to go on the Michigan State 35-yard line. Once again, it's a handoff to Howell, and this time he goes almost straight ahead after taking the handoff for another 7-yard gain. It's another first down for Michigan, first and 10. They're down now on the Spartans' 28-yard line. Single wing goes over to the right. Ted Kress taking the ball, dropping back, looking for a target. Sends one down for Lowell Perry, but it's over his head and intercepted by Jim Ellis. Jim Ellis gets the ball for Michigan State and brings it back to the 18-yard line. They lost 2 yards on the first play, and it's second down and 12. Michigan State's ball on their own 16. Again, the shift is to the right. Ball is is given over to Don McAuliffe. He goes back deep. Swings wide now, trying to get around the corner. Is tripped up on the line of scrimmage. Falls forward to gain 2 yards on the play. It's third down now and 10 yards to go. Michigan State's ball, and they're on their own 18-yard line. And they lead in the ball game 20-13. Single wing is over to the right. It's a quick kick. Usyk drops back, gets the boot away. Coming down over near the sidelines. And it rolls to a halt on the 42-yard line. After a 2-yard gain, Michigan now has the ball second and 8 on their own 44. Ed Kress with the ball, coming around right end. And he's tripped up after a 4-yard gain to make it third down and 4 yards to go for the Wolverines. Michigan's ball on their own 48. There's a quick pass to Tad Stanford, and it's complete. A gain of 9 yards on the play and another first down. That puts the ball on the Michigan State 43. And off goes to Ted Kress, who fumbles the ball. And it's recovered by Michigan State. Jack Morgan was the last to gain firm possession of that ball, and he takes it for Michigan State. And 2 plays later, it's Michigan State's ball, third down, 8 yards to go. They've worked their way down to the Michigan 35-yard line. Tommy Usyk back to throw a forward pass. Paul Decker's the target. There goes the ball, and it's complete for a gain of 13 yards. A first down for the Spartans. First and 10 for Michigan State. They're on the Michigan 23, the handoff goes to Billy Wells. Cutting inside left end, he cuts back now. He's hit after a gain of 7 yards by Merritt Green. Things are certainly going to the liking of Michigan State. They have the ball now, second down and 3 yards to go. And they're down in the Michigan 16-yard line. They're also out in front of this ball game by a score of 20-13. Roy Bolden takes the ball, powers his way up the middle for a 6-yard gain, and that's another first down for the Spartans. First and 10, and they're just a little better than 10 yards away from the goal line. The pitch out goes to the fullback, Evan Slonak. He tries it around the left side of the line, but is held for no gain. Second down, 10 yards to go on the 10. Michigan State in possession of the ball. Slonak again with the ball, this time cutting over right guard, and he bumps his way down for a 7-yard gain. Dave Tinkham made the stop, and it's third down and goal to go. Usyk with the ball, dropping back to throw a forward pass. He pitches one out to Leroy Bolden, who's in the end zone with the ball for a touchdown for the Spartans. This is a sad moment on the Michigan bench. They made the extra point, and at the end of the third quarter, the score was Michigan State 27, Michigan 13.
I'm Bud Wilkinson, football coach at the University of Oklahoma. Can you detect a long run in the making? I help you in this booklet, endorsed by the American Football Coaches Association, How to Watch Football. It features articles by other coaches and includes schedules. Pick up your free copy today at your Phillips 66 dealer.
After the kickoff, Michigan gained 13 yards, then lost the ball to Michigan State, who have it now first and 10 on their own 34-yard line. Out of the tee, the handoff goes to the right halfback, Vince Paisano, who cuts inside the left end, goes for a gain of 2 yards. To make it second down and 8 yards to go on the Michigan State 32. Tommy Usyk with the ball, dropping back to pass. He's rushed, but it's a screen pass, and he flips it into the arms of Dick Pannon. Pannon falls in behind his blockers, goes up the sidelines, and goes for a gain of 25 yards before he's tackled by Dave Tinkham. It's a first down for Michigan State. And after a 2-yard gain, it's now second and 8 on the Michigan 30-yard line. Usyk takes to the air once again. This time Ellis Duckett's the target, and the pass is complete. Duckett gets past the first tackler, goes for a gain of 20 yards before he's rolled to a halt. He hit the sideline at the 9-yard line, and it's Michigan State's ball, first and goal to go on the Michigan 9-yard line. The Sp- Spartans are out in front of Michigan 27-13. Don McAuliffe with the ball, hitting left guard, goes for a gain of 2 yards. After a penalty against Michigan State, we have it now, Michigan State's ball, 3rd and 22 on the Michigan 22-yard line. Music back to throw a forward pass. Don McAuliffe breaks into the clear. There goes the ball, and it's incomplete, out of his reach. And that makes it the Spartans' ball, 4th down, 22 yards to go on the Michigan 22-yard line. Off to Billy Wells, and he fades back to throw another forward pass. It's a wobbly pass, and it's incomplete. Michigan takes over on downs, and they have it 1st and 10. They're on their own 22-yard line. Single wing goes over to the right. Ball comes to the fullback. There's the buck lateral, winding up in an end around with Lowell Perry carrying the ball, and he goes for a gain of 5 yards. Next play saw Michigan gain 2 to make it 3rd down and 3 yards to go. The ball is just short of their own 30-yard line. Ed Cressett, tailback with the ball. Dropping back now, looking for a passing target. Flips a short one to Ted Topa, the quarterback, who slips and falls to a gain of 3 yards. That made it a 1st down for Michigan, and then they ran into nothing but trouble. They wound up 4th down, 6 yards to go on their own 36-yard line. Into punt formation with Bill Billings back. Gets the kick away, all right. It's a high kick bounding down and coming to a halt. It rolls to a stop right around the 20-yard line as the ball game ends, Michigan State 27, Michigan 13. This was the 45th meeting between these two teams in the nation's keenest intrastate rivalry. Although the Spartans won their 3rd in a row by upending the Wolverines today, Michigan still holds an edge of 33 victories over their cross-state rivals as opposed to 9 losses. There were 3 ties. Now, as this game goes into the record books, let's listen to a little music.
Know that she's appreciated when you take her riding in your car.
Show her smooth performance. Show her you got class.
Simply fill your tank with Phillips 66 gas.
She'll love you for your pickup.
She'll adore you for your speed.
That Phillips 66 is just the gasoline you need.
That's how your gal will know that she's appreciated.
Remember, it's Phillips.
Phillips 66 gas.
Phillips 66 can do plenty for you.
Get up and go. Your car will go. Phillips with Phillips.